hand clap of praise this morning. I said, let's give the Lord a hand clap of praise this morning. He didn't have to wake us up, but he did. Amen. Somebody, somewhere, did get up this morning, but we have a chance to give God some praise this morning, so let's not miss that opportunity. Amen. Thank God for this chance, this opportunity to share the word of God with you this morning. We'll be coming from the fifth chapter of the book of Matthew. So go ahead and get ready to find that scripture in your Bibles. We'll be starting at the 13th verse. Amen. You know, so many times we just go through life and just follow the motions, go through the motions. And we don't find our purpose. We don't fulfill our purpose. We just go with the flow. And God has called us to do far greater than just go with the flow.
Amen.
Amen. So turn with me to the fifth chapter of Matthew. If you got it, say, I got it.
Got it.
If you don't, say, hold up a minute. Amen. Just read one verse. And the word says, you are the salt of the earth. But if the salt has lost its savor, wherewith shall it be salted? It is thenceforth good for nothing, but to be cast out and to be trodden under foot of men.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Let us pray. Father God, we come to you today, Lord. We ask that you just touch in a mighty way, Lord. We ask that the words that come out of my mouth can touch somebody's heart, Lord. Lord, I pray that you just take over, Lord, and let your word go far and never come back void, Lord. We actually just bless in a mighty way in this ministry, Lord, that somebody's heart would be touched, Lord, that somebody would step up to the plate, Lord, and fulfill their destiny, Lord. We ask you to just keep blessing this ministry as a whole, Lord. Thank you for our pastor, Lord, for his leadership, Lord, for his guidance, Lord, and for his constant attitude, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
For a little while, I want to talk about the flavor of your life.
Yes,
amen.
Yes.
So, in the book of Matthew, chapters 5, 6, and 7, it is known as Jesus' Sermon on the Mount.
Yes,
amen. In this sermon, there's a great emphasis on your moral, on his moral teachings. It's the longest teachings of Jesus in the New Testament. Amen?
Amen.
Jesus talks about the Beatitudes.
Come on now.
The Lord's Prayer. Christian discipleship. The role of the law. Relationships with others. And how we are to get along. Right? He also talks about how do you deal with people that hurt you or that sinned against you. It's a lot.
Amen.
How to manage your finances.
Yeah.
Fasting. Praying. How to deal with your worries.
Yeah.
He talks about judging folks.
Yeah.
In these chapters, he talks about a lot of things. Can I get amen?
Amen.
But in verse 13, chapter 5, he says, you.
Yeah.
This includes me.
Yeah.
So somebody look at somebody next to him and say, we.
We
are the salt of the earth.
We are
amen.
Amen.
See, why did he say salt? Back in those times, salt was a valuable commodity.
All right.
It was not only used to flavor foods. That's what we think of salt. I got to add some salt to this. But it was indispensable in preserving food as well. Amen. It was also used as a method of trade and currency. And, you know, doing research, did you know that coming from the word salt was the word salary? The word salary. Everybody know what salary is, right?
Yes.
If they don't have your check right, you're gonna cause an uproar. You're gonna put your Christianship aside, you're gonna act a fool. Amen?
Amen.
That's my check up. With my check. Amen?
Amen?
But the word salary comes from the Latin word salari, which means salary, which has the root word of sal, or salt. All right? So now you know how valuable salt is.
Yes,
even in ancient Rome, they paid them in salt.
Yes.
That was their wages. So why does the Bible say that you're the salt of the earth? Why not be the iron of the earth? Why not be the gold of the earth? Those things carry value. They're traded worldwide.
That's right.
You can probably check any element on the periodic table and say why he didn't say this, that, or the other. You know, gold and iron, they have a lot of value. They're traded all over the place. But why salt? Yeah. Why salt? See, when we think about salt around here in these parts, we think about a whole bunch of salt in one of those little kiddie pools full of crawfish, and we put water in it, and we try to get ready to boil them crawfish. We salt them up, trying to call ourselves trying to purge them, right? But we think about it also as we got to put it on a little something to eat, something that don't taste that good. But how about we think about salt, we think about that person's house that always want to cook, that we go by. It don't really taste all that right, but we always got to throw a little salt on it, but we do it without them looking so we don't hurt their feelings.
Right.
How about that? But we do that to do what? To give it a little flavor. Amen?
Right.
You know? And in my research, I found that salt has over 14,000 uses.
Wow.
14,000 uses. And I can imagine that if you ask some of, let's see, some of our experienced people, the uses that they know about salt may not be the things that they used it for, but they heard somebody else use it for down the line. And somebody told that person. And there'd be a lot of things that you probably never, ever, ever heard of or thought of. Well, we are the salt of the earth. We have uses that we haven't even begun to explore. Amen. Some people go their whole life to never uncover or use the talents and gifts that God has given them.
Amen.
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 So why he said we're the salt of the earth? God has blessed us to be who and what we are today.
Amen.
Think
Amen.
About this. As ferocious as the animal, as the lion and the tiger is, does he give them rule of the world?
No.
Does he give them the authority that he gives us as man?
No.
He doesn't. He gives us the mindset to handle them and every other animal on earth. Again, salt, 14,000 uses.
Amen.
How many uses does men have?
Amen.
If we took the time to tally up, not just me, not just you, but men everywhere, and tally up all the gifts and talent that they have, that list will probably go on for days and days and days. It will be a staggering number. I'm sure 14,000 would be small when you think about all the uses and the talents and gifts of man.
Amen.
But when I think about all those 14,000 uses, I think about the scripture, I call it the I can do scripture. Amen. Philippians 4:13. I can do what? I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. What can I do? I can walk for Jesus. I can talk for Jesus. I can pray for Jesus, to Jesus. I can bless somebody in Jesus' name. Amen. I can teach in Jesus' name. Sometimes I can sing in Jesus' name.
Amen.
There's nothing that you can't do without God. Amen.
Amen.
You could even have a desire to get a better job, but first you gotta have your job yourself and take care of the job that you do have. That's how you get blessed with a better job.
Right.
Take care of what you got, and he's gonna bless you with more. Amen.
Amen.
In reading this text, I realized that the things that I can do. And I said, what else can I do that can impact the world so I can be some salt of the earth?
Yes.
I can follow Jesus.
Yeah.
I can be an example to somebody. Because
yeah.
somebody always looking at you.
Yeah.
I can share the word. Yeah. I can be humble.
Yeah.
I can pray for myself.
Yeah.
I can pray for my family.
Yeah.
I can pray for my enemies.
Amen.
Amen.
Come on now.
So let's talk about salt. Salt has over 14,000 uses. But I'm going to talk about this. Salt is a preservative.
Yes.
In some situations, some cases, salt is used as a preservative. And salt preserves the freshness in certain foods.
Yes.
Amen?
Amen.
So how does that relate to us? Well, we should be able to preserve the word of God.
Right.
We should be able to preserve God's purpose.
Yes.
The world is not preserving God's purpose in God's word, but it's up to us as Christian disciples to do that.
Yeah.
Standing for truth is preparing, is preserving God's word. Amen.
Amen.
Again, I said salt is a seasoning. It adds flavor or it pulls flavor out of food. Yeah. Amen?
Amen.
We as Christians, we should be able to pull some goodness out of people.
Yeah.
Amen. Amen? We should be able to be around somebody and impact them to do greater. Amen?
Amen.
Too many times, we want to call people out on the stuff that they did wrong. We want to call them out on the things that we know that they did negatively. Amen? Amen. We want to condemn them for the things that we know. We know we ain't no good ourselves.
Amen?
Amen. Everybody got something going on with them. Or been somewhere, or been through something.
Amen. Amen.
But it's up to us to pull out the good in folks.
Yes,
amen. I don't know about you, but I want people around me that's going to make me better.
Amen.
I want somebody that's going to make me better. Amen. I want to be shown and influenced to live better. I want to walk better. I want to talk better. I want to be able to give better. I just want to be better. Amen.
Amen.
I don't want to be around people that's going to put down on me and highlight my shortcomings. I need some salt in my life. Amen. If you surround yourself or you surrounded by people that ain't bringing the best out of you, you need to change your surroundings and get rid of some folks. Amen. Too many people that's going to put down on you. Think about it. We go to some churches, they're going to put down, they're going to beat you down, they're going to beat you down. But y'all, God wants us to share what? The good news. He wants us to share the good news. Yes, the wages of sin is death. But the gift of God is eternal life. Amen. I love to hear the gift of God's eternal life in the day of the week. It's going to inspire me to be greater than hearing what I did wrong. What's going to keep me? You know, we know that the wages of sin is death, but the reward is the gift of eternal life. Amen.
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 See, I was thinking about how can we put this together? Talking about believers.
Yeah.
You know, we always use the word we are believers. Believers, right?
Yeah.
And everybody's good with saying, okay, I'm a believer. I'm a believer. But being a believer is not enough. Being a believer is just like being a container of salt sitting on this podium right here. It's just sitting there. It's in the room.
Yeah.
We believe it can season some food.
That's right.
But it's just sitting there. Sitting on the table, should I say. Well, guess what? We believers come to church. Believers are in the community.
Yeah.
Believers at work. Believers at family functions. Believers are in the midst of everything that's going on. But what God is calling for us to be is more than just believers. He wants us to be doers. He wants us to be doers. He said, go and make disciples. Duplicate it into the life of someone else. Amen. It's not just enough to show up here on Tuesday and on Sundays. We should be making an impact when we go to work. We should be making an impact at home. We should be making an impact in our community. We should be making an impact in our schools. At the basketball game, at the football game, by your auntie house, by your cousin house, when you're going out to Applebee's to get them dollar treats, you should be making some type of impact somewhere. Amen. God has called us to duplicate and make disciples. If you have a relationship with Jesus Christ, it is your responsibility to share the gospel with someone else. Somebody say seasoning.
Seasoning.
In my opinion, you know, I was thinking like, why? Some people are not comfortable sharing the word or sharing the good news of Jesus Christ. Because some people believe that they aren't qualified or equipped to do so. How are you not qualified? Some people don't have the confidence. Some people don't feel like they are qualified or worthy to share the word or share their experiences with Jesus. But I'm going to tell you this. As somebody who's here to share the word, you probably don't always feel like you're not worthy or qualified. But you got to be able to share your experiences because you may feel like you're not worthy or qualified, but think about this. The word is what connects us with Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Amen?
Yes.
That's a big responsibility.
Yes.
But we have to accept that call. Yes. Amen? It connects us with our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen? So that makes you think, wait a minute, am I called to do this? Yes, you're called to do this because Jesus has done something in your life.
Amen.
Let me tell you this. You look back over your life, I bet you can say right now that you are more equipped than you was a year ago.
Amen.
I bet you more equipped than you were 2 years ago.
Amen.
What about 5 years ago? I wish I had about two or three people here that agree with me.
Amen.
Somebody, someone knows that they're not where they used to be. Amen. got to remember this. It's always somebody, somewhere, that can use a word from you. How can I share Jesus with someone else? It's what people say. I'm not a scripture quoter. I haven't been saved that long. I've been gone from the church too long. Oh, and to be real honest, I never really paid attention in church when I came. I just came because I came. I was always taught to come. But let me ask you this. Have you ever been sick? You can share with somebody. Who healed you? Who healed you? Because if somebody healed me, if Jesus healed me, I'm going to share with somebody else. Amen. Have you ever been hungry? They know what you was going to eat. Matthew 25 and 35 says what? For I was hungry and you gave me food. I was thirsty and you gave me drink. I was a stranger and you welcomed me. I'm going to share that with somebody because there was a time when I realized I may not know where my meal was coming from. It may have been something else in your life. You didn't know where it was going to come from. But God came through and provided for you. Amen. Amen. Go on, look up. Have you ever been hurt before? Nobody can get you through that hurt but God.
Yes.
You ever been broke?
Yes.
Has anybody ever been broke up in here? Didn't know where it was going to come from? We always talk, Luke 6 and 38 says, good measure. Press down. Shake it again. Run it over. Amen. Somebody somewhere in your life can get close to the Lord just by your testimony. Amen.
Amen.
Somebody knows that at some point in your life you were sick. Have you had people here that been sick before?
Amen.
That's been down and out. That they gave up on. Amen.
Yes.
Want to be your mission and your job to tell somebody who healed you?
Yes.
Who fed you?
Yes.
Who blessed you and made you whole again? You were hungry, but not only did he feed you physically, now you're full off the word.
Yeah.
Amen. You were broke. You used to have to borrow money, but now people coming to you to borrow money. Amen. You got a job up here this morning. Amen. You can stand there and say, I may not be where I want to be, but I'm so glad I'm not where I used to be.
Yeah.
I am the salt of the earth. I have no longer sitting on the table. I'm no longer just in the room. Somebody help me up in here. See, I'm so glad that Jesus sprinkled me over here so I can add flavor over here. I'm so glad that Jesus sprinkled me over there so I can add some flavor over there. Amen. Somebody better help me up in here. Ain't the Lord all right?
Yeah.
He took someone like me who was just on the table and he used me to flavor somebody else. I made mistakes in my life, but he used me to be able to help somebody else not to make those same mistakes.
Yes.
Amen. Because
Amen.
I don't want nobody else to go through the things I went through because of my own undoing. Amen.
Amen.
See, in 2016, I was supposed to be gone if I listened to the doctors.
Yes.
Ain't nothing else we can do for you.
Yep.
I was just sitting on the table. I hadn't fulfilled my purpose in life. I'm thinking I'm about to check out of here. I'm thinking about my kids. I'm over thinking about what I'm going to be able to do, how I'm going to make sure that they're set for when I'm gone.
Yeah.
But he gave me another chance to get it right.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
I'm not standing here because of me. I'm standing here because of my Lord and Savior.
Yeah.
Amen. The doctor said I wasn't going to make it, but look at me.
Huh.
Amen.
Amen.
They threw in the towel. The doctors threw in the towel. They sit there home and say, there's nothing else we can do for you. But you know what my God did? He took that towel, he threw it back.
Ah.
He threw it back. It ain't time yet. It ain't time yet. Amen. He said, at this time, he said, go back to Rock Sinai. He said, even though you live an hour away, go serve under your leader. Amen. He said, go add some seasoning to your family.
Yeah.
He said, go home and add some seasoning to your home. I just want to tell you again, I'm not here by an accident. We are here by God's providential will. Amen. We are here for a purpose. Let's find our purpose. Let's find where we can be some seasoning in that. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Find out where you can be some seasoning in that. Because there's a calling on your life that you're probably not paying attention to. There's a calling on your life that you're probably not listening to. But let me tell you something. If God called you to do something, he's going to get your attention.
Yeah.
Some type of way, shape, or form, he's going to get your attention. You can sit there and ignore God all you want to, and I'm going to tell you, he's going to get your attention. Let us step up to the plate before it's too late. Amen. Let's give it all in.